Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum ji. Let's continue our discussion on Bayesian learning. In the previous video, we introduced Bayesian learning framework very briefly. Let's formalize the concept and take it forward. In the context of supervised learning formulation, we had this data set D in which we have n training samples, where each training sample is in the D dimensional space. And for each sample, we have an associated label. We call the set of possible functions or candidate models as the hypothesis class. And in this hypothesis class, we can have a linear model, we can have a neural network, we can have a decision tree, we can have different models which we can use to relate input and output. And we call this model, this hypothesis class, we denote it with H. Just a minute. Yeah, so this is our H. For a given problem, we want to select the best hypothesis from this hypothesis class. That was our objective, which we defined in the very first lecture of the course. And we achieved this in Bayesian learning by finding the best hypothesis that is the most probable hypothesis in the hypothesis class, given the data and given some initial knowledge about the prior probabilities of the various hypotheses in H. We can use Bayes theorem to determine the probability of a hypothesis based on its prior probability, the observed data, and the probabilities of observing various data given the hypothesis. Okay, what do we mean by this? Okay, let's mathematically define this and we can shed some light on it. Find H that maximizes the distribution probability of hypothesis given data. So what we have here, probability that this hypothesis H of being true given the data we have. So this is the probability we want to compute for each H in the hypothesis class. And we will select the hypothesis for which we have the maximum valid probability, right? Or we select the hypothesis that maximizes this probability. In order to compute this probability, we can employ Bayes theorem to reformulate this probability in this form. The probability of H given D, what we want to determine, that is equal to probability of D given H times probability of H divided by probability of D. We give special names to each of these terms here. What is probability of H? That is probability of hypothesis being true. This is what we call the prior probability. This is our belief about H, or that's coming from our past experiences. The prior probability is the probability that the hypothesis holds before we look at training data. So probability of H does not depend on the data. Right. What is probability of D? This is the probability of the training data given no information about the hypothesis. So this is independent of hypothesis. This is just a distribution of the data. Right? Because distribution is sampled from some universal distribution. Right? So what is the probability that the data you're getting is from that universal distribution? This is the probability of your data. And it does not depend on hypothesis class. What is probability of D given H? We refer to it as a likelihood function because it is quantifying the probability of observing data given hypothesis H. Right? And finally, P, probability of H given D, is our posterior. This is called posterior probability, and it quantifies the influence of data on our prior probability or our confidence that H holds after observing the data. And we compute this posterior probability. This is what we want to compute, but we compute it using Bayes' theorem by computing probability of D given H times probability of H. And if you note here, this probability of D, so this term does not depend on H. So if we are finding H that maximizes the posterior distribution, we only focus on likelihood function and our prior. Prior, it reflects our prior knowledge about the candidate hypothesis H. And likelihood function, you update given H, what is the probability that, what is the probability of observing data D given hypothesis function H? Or how likely that a given hypothesis is generating the data you have? Okay, let's formulate this maximization problem that find H that maximizes the distribution probability H given D. Okay, we want to find H that maximizes the distribution or probability. I'm calling it distribution because this is in fact, if it is discrete, this is probability mass function. And what mass function is in fact a distribution, right? So maximizing posterior probability, we can have what we call maximum a posterior probability, right? So this is what we call MAP, maximum a posterior hypothesis. And we obtain this MAP hypothesis by maximizing probability of H given D over hypothesis class H. And as I said earlier, we do this by employing the Bayes' theorem. So in fact, of maximizing this, we maximize this. And since in the denominator, we have probability of D that does not depend on hypothesis H, so this is equivalent to, if we drop this and instead we maximize likelihood times prior, right? So this is our MAP hypothesis or maximum a posterior hypothesis. It is also called MAP estimation, that we are estimating hypothesis that best explains the data. What's the interpretation of this? So the interpretation is that we begin with prior distribution of hypothesis. So we assume that we have some prior information about the hypothesis H. And then using this candidate hypothesis, we determine the probability of data given hypothesis. And then we use these two, we update posterior probability and we obtain posterior probability distribution. And we select the one, so we select the hypothesis for which the posterior probability distribution is maximized. And that is our MAP hypothesis. Okay, let's talk about one more type of hypothesis, which is maximal likelihood hypothesis. In MAP, if each hypothesis is equally probable, we can reformulate MAP hypothesis. And instead, we maximize the probability of data given hypothesis. So we drop the prior information. If every hypothesis in hypothesis class is equally probable. In MAP, we maximize this, but if probability of H is same for every H, we can drop probability of H. And instead, we only maximize the likelihood function. Right, this is called maximizing a likelihood function. that for each h in the hypothesis class, you find the probability that is data given hypothesis. That if you select an hypothesis, this probability explains that what is the probability that this hypothesis is generating this data. Okay, let's take an example to further understand maximal likelihood estimation. We take a very simple example. We want to predict the face, sight, head or tail of the loaded coin. So we have a biased coin, a loaded coin, and we want to find that if you toss a coin, what is the probability that you get head or tail? Right? If X is our event, we want to find out that what is the probability that X is equal to H, or probability that X is equal to tail. In fact, since we only have two events, it's a Bernoulli random variable. X is a Bernoulli random variable. Probability of X is equal to tail is equal to 1 minus probability that X is equal to head. Okay, we assume that we have a data set in which we take n and we conduct experiment n times, and we have an outcome of n events. So your first time you get head, second time you get tail, third time you get head, and so on and so forth, right? So in total, we have outcomes of n events. Intuitive prediction would be count the number of heads and divide it by n. And if this quantity is greater than 0.5, head is more probable when you toss next time. Right? It makes sense. Let's apply machine learning, let's apply maximal likelihood estimation to this problem. Okay. We want to estimate probability of X is equal to head. And therefore, we can say hypothesis space can be parameterized by a single variable such that probability of X is equal to head is equal to theta, and probability of X equal to tail is 1 minus theta. So in our hypothesis class, we have a different hypothesis function. And if for each hypothesis function, we have a different variable theta. Right? So theta is my variable, theta is defining my hypothesis class. Or we can say we want to find theta such that probability of data given H is equal to probability of data given theta is maximized. So I have replaced H with theta because theta, now the variable theta is parameterizing my hypothesis class. If we assume independence between successive trials, or if we assume independence between events, we can have probability of data given hypothesis as probability of the first event, the second event, times second probability of third event, and so on and so forth, right? So you take a product of all the probabilities, right? This is probability. Okay, on left hand side, we have a joint probability, right? And because we are assuming independence, we know that a joint probability can be written as a product of individual probabilities. And therefore, probability of data given H is probability of Xi given theta. So given theta means you know the hypothesis. For a given hypothesis, you want to find what is the probability that Xi given theta. Or to very precise, probability of Xi is equal to head given theta. So we want to find the value of theta for which this is maximized. So we use log of the likelihood function instead of maximizing this. So since log is monotonous, if you maximize log of the likelihood function, that is equivalent to you are maximizing a likelihood function, right? This is a likelihood function, this is what you want to maximize, but instead you maximize the log of this. So using the property of log, log of product is equal to summation of the log of individual terms. So if I move log inside, I can replace this product with a summation. Right? And maximal likelihood estimate would be given by maximizing probability of D given H, and instead we maximize log of this, which is maximizing summation of log of individual probabilities. And at times we refer to maximal likelihood estimation as maximizing the log likelihood function. Right? Okay, let's solve this. In fact, we can solve this analytically for this problem. We have, if the number of heads in the data is NH, so you conduct trials N times and number of heads in the data is NH, right? And if we get the maximal likelihood problem, we want to maximize, okay, what did we have? So we had a summation of, let me explain. So we had this quantity, this is I is equal to 1 to n log of pxi given theta, right? So if I express this in terms of using the probabilities, I can write as, so we have nh number of heads times log of theta, and we have n minus nh for which you get a tail, and the probability of getting tail is 1 minus theta. Right? And if you take derivative of this with respect to theta, we get nh over theta minus n minus nh over 1 minus theta times derivative of 1 minus theta, which is minus, and therefore you get this minus sign. So this minus, this negative sign is due to the derivative of 1 minus theta, which is negative 1. And you can solve this, and when severity is equal to 0, you can solve for theta, and what we get is theta ml is equal to, theta is equal to number of heads in when you conduct n trials. And this matches with our intuition. So this is a maximal likelihood estimate of the probability that when you toss the coin next time, you get head. Right? So that was about MAP estimation and maximal likelihood estimation. So we stop here and we'll continue next video. Thank you, Joe.